Yeah. Welcome to the church, volume 2. Exclusive 213. Got my nephew Nate Dogg in the house. Nate Dogg, holla at him. Where you at?
Riding in my car. And I'm listening to the radio.
What's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. I am Caliente Nancy. Okay, you guys, so let's start with a get ready with me natural look. I am going to be chit-chatting with you as I get ready. I do want to let you know the products that I'm currently using. And excuse my nails. I am not wearing nails. I did do my nails the past 3 weeks, I believe, or 2 weeks. And I'm not going to lie to you. For me, when I do my nails, when one of them break or like even like chips off, I feel so uncomfortable that I take all of them off. So stay tuned. I'm trying to figure it out how to do my nails next. I don't know if I'm gonna go get them done or I'm gonna go ahead and do them myself. So as you guys know, I do most of the things on my own. So yeah, so I'm very excited, you guys, to be back and bring you guys a makeup look. And you guys been requesting it for such a long time, so that's why I'm here. And starting it off, I would like to do something like for an everyday look. So let's jump to it, right? So okay, I'm gonna be prepping my skin. Right now I don't have anything on my skin. My face is freshly washed. I do wash my face daily with the daily scrub from Neutrogena Clean and Clear. So I love how it leaves my face, even though if I don't wear something right after moisturizer, my skin is not as dry. But I am gonna let you guys know I do have an oily skin. I'll be going with my Mario, and I'm gonna just go ahead and spray it. I literally shower with this, and this will be on, let me see, rose water. It smells delicious. Like, I love it. Some of it just went to my mouth, but I don't care. Okay, so there it is. So I do prep my skin with this. I prime it with this. I use it as my base for my makeup. And I love how it looks. Like, I literally like how this looks. And I'm like, I'm living for Mario Cosmetics skincare products. Like, I really love it. So after I use my spray, I am going to be using my day cream moisturizer. And it's this one right here. I'll just place a little bit on my T-zone. Just like that. I just dot it. And I am going to be using just like a bit, because like I say, I do have oily skin. And this day cream, it feels really, really good on my skin. But it moisturizes. Aprovecho de Rimi con gozo para mandarte pa' o también. No mentira ni tu falsedad. Me voy pa' la calle esta noche a rumbear. Me bebo dos tragos y te voy a olvidar. Me voy con la baby que quiera jugar. No quiero mentira ni tu falsedad. Me voy pa' la calle esta noche a rumbear. Me bebo dos tragos y te voy a olvidar. Me voy con la baby que quiera jugar. Just so everything could be still like I would say dewy, because I don't want it to look all dry, because the Urban Decay does dry so much that I don't want it to look powdery. So I'm just going to spray one more time. And with that said, I am going to be going with my concealer. And the concealer I'm going to be using is from Tarte Shape Tape in the color Light Medium. Okay.
I put the fierce and bad character, and the kind of living town.
this BH Cosmetic palette. And this is the cream contour. So I'll be using these colors at the bottom. And then this one's right here, I'll sometimes use it for to highlight and brighten the look the most. So that'll be this color right here. Like, I like to brighten up the under eyes of my face just for them to pop back, like to pop out. Like, I love that look, like the under eye look. People sometimes let me know, like, dang, what type of concealer you're using. They just think it's only one, but I actually like to mix in just for it to give you like a bright look, okay? Baking, so practically I'm gonna just be setting on my concealer, and I do leave it for such a long time just because, like I said, I'm very oily, so you guys. So I'm gonna be using my Laura Mercier, and let me see if it has the color. It's in translucent. So this is the packaging, this is how it looks like. So I am gonna be setting it as well with my beauty blender, and I'll show you guys how I do it. Oh my god, you guys, like, honestly, I love it. I love the Laura Mercier as for me because it really dries up all my pores. So like this, and I go very light when I start coming in the inner in front of my eyebrow. Like, I don't want to go too dark, and my eyebrows, they're not like even at all. I really try to get them as even as possible, but it does not work. And then from the front of my eyebrow, what I like to do is just like go upwards. Like that. Okay? Just like that. Basically, that is it. And then I'll just be going in and cleaning my eyebrows. Now that I have the eyebrows done, I am going to go ahead and clean them up. So what I do from the top, I use the foundation that's closest to the color that I have. And then from the inside, I'll be doing the concealer that I'm going to go ahead and prime my lid with. So I'm going to be going in with a Tarte shape tape. And I am just going to go in with a flat brush. I love this brush. And this was from like a brush set that I got. It already lost the name. Like, it doesn't even have the name of the brush no more. But I love this brush, and I'm going to show it to you guys how this brush looks. This brush is like very flat, very, very flat. And I really like how it cleans out my eyebrow. So with that said, I am just going to rub just a little bit on the palm of my hand. And like I said, I like putting everything on the palm of my hand. By the time I'm done, it's going to look like a canvas. And so I'm just going to be picking up very little amount, like very slightly. And I am gonna start from the inner corner of my eye, just like that. I don't know if you guys can see, but I will zoom in the camera for you guys. And since Tarte shape tape, it's very, very full coverage. Like, I really love how it cleans up your eyebrow. So just like that, you see? So I just drag it downwards, since that's going to be my base for my concealer for my eyelids to begin my eyeshadow. So I'll just drag it all the way down. And you guys, I do apologize if I'm talking a little bit too fast or I'm going through it too fast. This would be like my first tutorial on makeup, like I was explaining to you guys. So let me know if you guys want me to slow down or take more time on reviewing what I'm doing. Let me know, please. So, okay, once that is all in, I'm going to go ahead and already drag it down my eyelid. And with my Murphy palette, and this is the palette 352, and I've been mentioning it in all my YouTube vlogs. And this is a really go-to palette, because you guys, I'm living for all the colors in here. Let me just show you. Check out all the colors in the palette. They are beautiful. Beautiful colors. Like, I am impressed with every single color in this palette. But, man, one thing I could do say is that the only thing I could not say this palette didn't do for me, it was just one little thing, you guys. And it's a transition color. A transition color for me would be like a perfect, basically like a cream color. And I would say it's more like a cream, in between a cream and a nude. That's the only thing. This palette, rather than that, is the best palette that I have for Murphy palettes. For Murphy brushes, and I freaking love it. Like, I love it. So let me tell you guys the color that I'm gonna be using for the transition, just because it's not in this palette. It will be on my NYX Happy Birthday palette, and this has neutral colors as well. And look at you guys, it's a beautiful palette as well. And I'll be going in with, I would say this color right here. This is the color that I'll be using. Whoops. So this is a palette that I'll be using right on the color I'll be using. Just because this is the perfect for me to blend in any color on top of it. Like any type of color. So for that, I am going to be going in with a flat brush. And I'll be using my Hello Kitty. Let me just show you. This is the brush, how it looks. It's very flat. And I just use it for this color. Like, it's very pretty how it looks. Let me just show you guys. So I just dab into it like pretty deep. I'm not gonna lie to you. I do not, if you guys notice, I do not set my eyes with any translucent powder. I'll just set it with my own eyeshadow palette. Eyeshadows that I choose from my palettes, and it works perfectly fine for me. So let me just show you guys how I go in. And I'ma just be setting it all over the lid. Like all over the lid. And it's beautiful. Like very beautiful. It's a pretty neutral color, you guys. Like, I love it. I love how it looks. It's very, very, very neutral. Like, you guys could see the difference. Like, look at the difference. And the same thing I'm going to do to the other eye. So once I have my both eyes prepped already, I'm gonna be using a soft brown to start with in my crease, because I want to keep it very neutral for you guys. I didn't want to go too crazy on my first makeup look, get ready with me. So I am gonna be using a very neutral colors, because they're all gonna be neutral for me. And we'll be using, for my transition, will be this color right here, you guys. Okay, we're gonna be using this color right there. And this color, we're gonna be applying it only at the crease, okay? Only at the crease. And with that, I am gonna be using, let me see, one of my Murphy brushes. So it'll be this one right here. And this is how the bristles look. Okay, you guys? And what I'm gonna be doing is just picking up the color and just concentrating in the crease, okay? And I'll be going in with, let me see here, I have all the colors name for you, and this thing is backwards. Can I even get it together, you guys? Okay, so I might be going in with, let me see, Flux. I think I like this color to go in with my crease. So I'm gonna be using that color. And I'm gonna be just apply it slightly into my crease, okay? Like very slightly into my crease. So it's gonna be like this. And I'm gonna go ahead and apply it circling motions. So it's gonna be in circle motions, you guys. And the more you build, like the more you put on, like the more you blend it, it looks like the color, it builds on its own. And like, I really didn't pick up as much product, and it does have a little bit of fallout, but that's fine because I still have my translucent powder on my face, so I just swipe it out. That's all I do. So I'm gonna just keep it in my inner corner. I'm going to start off on my outer corner, taking it in all the way to my inner corner of the eye. So it's gonna look just like that, you guys. And look at how pretty, like, these colors are beautiful, like beautiful. So far I'm only using two colors, because I have my translucent color and all over my eyes, and then I have my next color only on my crease. Okay, so with the third color, I am just only gonna apply it. So this one, I'm gonna take it all the way far out, because I like for my eye to look like it's stretched out. Just like that. Just for it to look like it was stretched out. Like that. Like, I like how it looks like that. Just like that, okay? With that said, I am gonna be going with the color, let's go back to the colors. It's gonna be, you know what, you guys, I am feeling in the zone. Let's go with the in the zone right here. Let's go with the in the zone. I have not yet tried this color, so I am just gonna apply it in my eyelid, giving it just a look like a wing eyeliner. So it's gonna be very defined, nothing too crazy. Sorry. It's gonna be defined like a smoky eyeliner, nothing crazy. So I am gonna be using one of my angle brushes, and this is from Murphy as well, from Murphy Brushes, and it looks like that. I've been using it in the past because I just like to like wing my eye just to make an illusion of an eyeliner. And I am gonna be going with that color. It looks pretty nice. Like, let's give it a try. And I am gonna be going very soft just to create the line. Just like that. Did you guys see it? Just like that. It's so pretty. Like, it looks so pretty. And I'm going to be dragging it all the way inside. And I'm going to be doing that to the same thing. But... going with the same color we went inside my crease, and I'll just be working it at the bottom, and I did it very slightly, you guys, so just like that. Okay, just like that. I'm gonna be going in with my Naked Urban Decay flush. It looks just like that. And I'm gonna be using my brown sock color, this one right here, whoops, right there. And I'm gonna just be applying it all over where I basically contour. That's where I'm gonna go ahead, and it does have some fallout, so I need to dust that. Blush, and I'm gonna be using my MAC blush, and I think it's the name Peaches. You can no longer see the name, but this is how it looks. The color is very pretty. Like, I really like how it looks. So going in with my BH Cosmetic Wild and Radiant. Okay, you got me. And look at this. Look at this palette. Look at this beautiful colors. Okay, this has deep, beautiful colors. And I am gonna be going in with this color. Let me swatch it for you guys right quick. This color, it's beautiful. Like, you guys, I don't know if you guys could see it in camera, but it's right there. This is the one right there. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do. I am going to be spraying it all over and applying the highlight right after, okay? Okay, so next I am gonna be now doing my lips, and this is gonna close the look. So finally we are done with this look, and for my lips I am gonna be going in with, let's see, Buxom Cosmetics. I am in love with this little let me see, I would say kit. I honestly put it together because they did not came together, they came separately. So let me show you the lip gloss. It's from Buxom and it's in the shade Selena's. I do get it a lot. And the lip liner that I'll be using, oh my god, I just dropped it. It's gonna be, let me show you guys how it looks. And this is actually, let me see, I cannot really read the color, but really what the this color does is just like pops up the look of your lips when you outline it. So it looks like this. So what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be outlining my lips. I'm not gonna go out very far out. I'm gonna just keep it like very, I would say very similar to how my lip shapes are at. Okay, you guys?
Lo que tú buscas, calienta tanto que asusta, sabes lo que te gusta, te gusta, te gusta, teniendo fuego en el suelo, dando estrella en el cielo, y te diré lo que quiero, si tú te quedas conmigo.
You guys, this really completes my look. This is really my go-to everyday makeup look. So with that said, you guys, thank you so much for watching this video, and I really hope you enjoy it. Getting ready with me. Like, I love listening to music while do my makeup, and another thing about my hair, so a little chit chat, it was just a feeling of changing my looks. I always do that. I always like changing up my looks. I am going to darken my hair more because I feel like my roots are coming out already and they're getting bright. So let me know what you guys thought, or let me know, anywho, let me know what you guys want to see next. And this is it, you guys. So with that said, if you guys are new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe, give this video a thumbs up, also hit that bell button so whenever I upload a video, you guys are the first one to watch. So thank you, you guys.